Pop quiz. What is the fastest way to get GP in Guided Fate Paradox? You're probably thinking it's using Godly Purse along with the Pawpaws and making a run through a really far-end floor of Advanced or X-Advanced and just getting all those money bag drops. Sure, that may give a whole lot of GP right away for every single enemy you defeat, but it turns out there's a method that is so much faster and much more reliable. In fact, how would you like to get 300 million GP on a single floor? Yeah, that's right, on a single floor. It's possible, and it's only possible because of a certain feature or design with how shop guards are. Yeah, that's right, shop guards. Aren't those things so overpowered, though? It turns out that if you can get some really powerful equipment, not necessarily this powerful, just even start it. However, if you can get powerful enough, mainly on defense, you can actually do shop guard grinding very effectively. And that's pretty much what this video is going to be all about. I'm going to explain just exactly how you do it. I'll explain the defense thresholds and whatnot later on, but the key thing that you really need to do is set up the divinigram in the proper way. For Renya, you need to focus as much as possible on icons so that stats grow as quickly as you can get them to grow. The sooner you can get the required defense, the sooner you can get started. So, that means you have to keep the mods to a bare minimum, and I'll explain the ones you need. For stage 1 of the process, you need this so you can keep at it longer if necessary. This is kind of self-explanatory, though. Keep these icon polishers because they basically are free icons in a sense, extra stats for accelerated growth. This one is an absolute must because as long as you keep defeating shop guards, EN will never run out. In fact, you'll actually be maintaining at 100% quite a lot. You can even go to 100% from zero because you're getting so many shop guards. This one is essential for pretty much the entire process. It speeds things up significantly. In fact, I could actually swap in a lot more accuracy for attack, getting attack down to like 300 and still get some good growth there. This one is essential for stage 1 of the process. This is self-explanatory along with this. Notice how I don't have HP booster or any of those capacity booster mods. If you're really starting out and low level and whatnot, consider using these equipment boosters. I would recommend this one the most because it's the easiest one to get to cover the three most important stats, which are defense, attack, and accuracy. You absolutely must have those. HP and speed can be included, but they're not a must. Do, when you put these in, max them at the 250%. I would suggest having up to 2 of these, because otherwise there just really ain't much practical space for it. This one is the easiest one to do. This one is the next easiest one to do, because there's plenty of attack and hit ones that you can include. These ones, not so easily, but you can probably put a shield booster to use to kind of get a start on it. This one you can't really get hit outside cosplay items, so I do not recommend this one. Which means you have to have a nature suit, which is probably much the easiest one you can get at first, or the cinder goods, or remember the other one. Nature suit means you have to get the boss and beginner martial arts. So, now with that known, the other absolute critical thing that you definitely cannot go without for getting the GP is none other than Demon Soul. The game's description is wrong, though. It's based on the enemy's max HP instead of yours. That means, because shop guards have a ton of HP because they're such high level, in case you're wondering, Advanced with max enemy boosting has 960,000 HP. Yeah, that's quite a fair chunk. By itself, with no energy sources directed to Demon Soul, you get 5% of the enemy's HP as GP. So if an enemy has, let's just say, 1,000 HP, you're going to get 50 GP. It don't seem like much at all. But if you direct one energy source to it, well actually for every energy source you direct to it, that adds increases by 2. So that means with all 6 energy sources, that is a big 17%, so that means 170 GP from that 1,000. Now that's just 1,000. Try 960,000. Yeah, you're really looking at some serious beast on HP and GP there, isn't it? So, you can see where that's coming from. But other than these essential ones, use as many icons as you absolutely can. Notice how I don't have the capacity boosters and I don't have the HP booster, among a few others as well. For the angel, however, Rakiel is the best for that, but his divinigram is so horribly designed that it's actually impossible to place X booster in here because, well, let's just show you. Okay, looks like it fits here, right? Aside from the mods that I currently have. But it doesn't work because this field here is blank, which means it cannot be placed no matter what. In fact, it is impossible to place this anywhere, no matter where you try to do it. The only possible place it works is here, but that also means you cannot have the burst up as well. So that's why Rakiel did not have that. So instead, I'm using Koroiel, which also has some other advantages to go with it. For this one, I have all five of her energy sources directed to X Booster, which does provide a very nice boost. Other than that, of course, you will definitely need Vital Gain and the usual stat boosters, but those are not a must in this case. Yeah, kind of a haphazard random setup. A lot of these are just for fun kinds of things. Just focus on big damage, but I can definitely get rid of a lot of them. This would actually help a lot for angels. This is not a must, but it's being used to cover up space on these. And that's the general setup I have for that. One last thing that you definitely need to do is you need to have it so that when you do finally get the appropriate shot, you need to have it so that the angel cannot use ranged attack or have skills that cause the angel to move when they use. These may seem like they do, considering it does grab the enemy, but the double skill is what gets used, and that's the problem. You have to change equipment to something that works with that, so it doesn't have range like that. Let's see. It could be a random combination like this. The skill for this will not be used unless it's a double. Yeah, I've got a level 4 that I'm trying to work on as well. But these work, so I'm going to use those. That doesn't have range. What else do you got? Although this has range, it's status effect only, and with attack high enough, it's not a big deal. But if all else, I can always use that. Granted, of course, I do need a flowing cape as well. The reason is, for needing this, is to get started. You absolutely have to have this just to get started with stages 2 and 3. So, all the essentials are done, which means it's now time to make sure you max the enemy boosting. Yes, max the enemy boosting. Why? Well, with higher level enemies, you level up faster. And with higher level enemies means they have more HP. So that means you get GP faster. So, in the end, it's well worth it. Max the enemies. It's gonna pay off in the long run. With that now all set up, what are the exact thresholds that you need for defense? For beginner, you need 117,000 defense, 125,000 to assure invincibility. However, the enemies level up so slowly that it's just not really worth it. The shop guards in this, I think, have something like 38,000 HP. I'm not exactly sure, but it's around there. Intermediate has 379,000 defense as the minimum, and level 1 equipment is what I recommend for starting with it, which is easy enough to get, especially when you have those equipment mods that are equipment boosters, as I like to call them. And yeah, you can pretty much easily get that, and not only that, Enemies level up much faster. They gain 5 levels every floor, which is 15 levels in with max boosting, as opposed to just 1 or 3 with that. And of course, you need 400,000 to assure invincibility. For advanced, you need 3 million defense just to get started, which is an awful lot, but pretty easy when you get that level 5 equipment, and level 6 that I'm about to get. However, for assured invincibility, you need 3.16 million. X-Advanced does not have shop guards and shop rooms. There is shop guards present, but they're not worth it because they're only in certain irregular rooms. And you need 75 million defense just to be able to tolerate them. It's not worth it. Advanced at least has shop rooms, and that is what the full key of the process is. And this is what I'm going to be using. When you start, you need to get leveling up as soon as you absolutely can. And for this, I would strongly recommend, at least for now, making Renya defeat an enemy. That way, I gain a whole lot of levels. In case you're wondering, already, yep, like I said, a single enemy, I can get enough defense in beginner martial arts. But not quite enough for intermediate, but you can see where that's going already. Now, at this point, let the angel do all the work. Of course, I could use cat ears to bring out all the enemies, so you can see where all the rooms are and the like, get a sense on that. And yes, another enemy with a whole bunch more levels. And more there, and I'm pretty much already almost ready to handle intermediate. And I can now already handle intermediate. Just level 19. It's actually something like 18 instead. But you get the idea. For the most part, to make the angel do as much of the work as you can, hold the circle and X buttons, and watch the video. You can see just how much faster that can actually be. Focus on the gate, but let the angel try to get as much as possible. But do try to speed things up. And in case you're wondering, that's one single floor, right? Look how much defense he's already got. So fast and powering up. If you really need to, consider moving your angel companion to where a whole bunch of enemies are, so that way your angel can attack. And even throwing enemies adjacent to the angel. Burst has normally replaced it. Angel is just going back and forth. In case you're wondering, if you want to learn how to recover SP, this works for wands and anything else that uses this area of effect shape, get 2 panels away, as you can see here, you can see the grid. Okay, and now use a skill that targets the weakness. Or, that's actually 20% of the original SP that's necessary. Money bags are not worth it at this point. The shop guards are so much faster and more effective. But do try to ignore enemies as much as you can, so you can miss that one right along the way. With Renya, of course, ignoring. Let the angel do the work, as I've explained. I use this to block the shot. Look fast and going through enemies like crazy. Goodness, that is fast. In case you're wondering, 1 million already. That grows so fast, doesn't it? If you need EN, you can have a core for 100 units. Every turn you spend uses 2. The AI in this game is so bad. You saw how the angel went in there and then came back and then just went back into it again. Buttons, you absolutely have to have Brave Leg in order to really do that. It's not essential you get every enemy, but do try to focus on the first rush through the first 10 floors as best as you can, because after the first 10 floors, you're going to get zombies alive. But do not throw these. Because otherwise, they'll explode and end up doing damage. And you get more pressure. Whatever you do, if you see an irregular room, do not go into it. They're just a waste of time. Angel's wasting his pee like crazy. This is a room that's glitched because just going around in circles. Let the mantis eat all the junk treasures here. Round and round. It's part of the really bad AI. Okay, there's the gate. Just ignoring the other enemies because after floor 10, you're gonna get much better stuff. Or no gate there, but there is no bonus. Okay, found the gate. Keep going. This room is glitched because the angel tends to go around in circles. Surrounded on all fours, having enough defense means you don't get hit by it. Circles. Now, at the caravan, sell the junk you might have picked up if necessary. Not a must, though. Don't bother buying anything because you're not going to be after it. Already, almost there. 60% of the way there. But what's coming up next is really when the speed is going to occur. Now, as you're doing this, listen for zombie cries. That's right, zombies. Now we're gonna be present. Harpies are nothing really special. Round in circles. Look like there's anything here. These ninja cats here have the ability to ignore defense if you're on the side or the rear. That didn't do any damage because that was a funnel attack. So you're fine. That's the biggest threat in here. Otherwise, everything else is fine. Okay, that's a dead end room, sort of. Maybe I ain't gonna go for that, so get it myself. Blitzed rooms, just going around in circles. It's part of the bad AI in this game. can see why it's so bad. If you don't know if there was any zombies in there, just check the messages. But you need to look for zombies. This is another glitch room, because you just go around in circles. And I can get an 8 on me. Yeah, an 8. If I'm adjacent like this, and one straight ahead, targeting the weakness, blue 8. Okay, who's this gate at? Yeah, there's a flickering dot. Yeah, I look for a flashing dot on the map. See where the gate is. Zombie! When you see those, set the angel's mode to don't move an inch, and try to throw the angel adjacent to the zombie, and let Renya go around getting the enemies instead, or you can just stay put and let the transients come to you, like this. There's another zombie, the idiot's gonna get it, so don't worry about that just a bit. This trash can cause some trouble. Yeah, I just got a number out of you. Okay. Get rid of that. Just put an E in. Okay. Get that one to resurrect. To resurrect a zombie, simply stand on the skull and fast forward a few turns. When you think it's done, step off of it. It didn't resurrect. Go back on it, fast forward a few turns, and just keep repeating. Always have them adjacent. If the skull is not where it is, there might be a trap there. You'll have to get rid of it. With Renya, go around looking for other zombies present. Put them to use. Don't look like there's any others, so God mode available. You'll want to get that charge, by the way. And now, for the fun. Notice his defense, already way up there. Now, with no other enemies around besides those resurrecting zombies, hold circle and X, and watch that level fly up like you've never seen before. So and just short of the necessary defense. And I now have my defense threshold that I need. Disable it from showing up. There is a way, though. And this is one of the key advantages of Coroliel. And that is this. And now, eat it. It also restores your SP. And of course, when you're done, set the angel's mode to fight as you see fit. Round and round it goes. There is a way to kind of stop that, and that's to get it right in the way. It doesn't always work, however. At this point, now that I have enough defense, I'm practically at the point of invincibility, I need to look for a map with dots on here that are fragile and don't move. Except in that case, that didn't work. All these move, so focus on the gate. And not the buttons. These money bags are still hardly worth anything. Okay, there's the gate. another zombie. Feel free to grind more on the zombie as necessary. Not a must, though, however, at this point. 6. That one's based on the front, and it's almost always based on the front. 'll let you come over. That was convenient. Chose the wrong side. Okay, see something that might be stronger for. Those are line walkers, as I call them. Very straight lines. And there's no shop here, so I could just let the companion blast the zombie. But it's not really worth it at this point. Not as worth it, unless of course you got several of them. Several being 3 or more, or even 4, depending on what your preference is. Of course, you can still have the angel working on the zombies as you're doing this. Okay, and this one follows soon after. No buttons. No buttons there. These all move, so I'm just going to focus on the gate. Another zombie, but I'm not sure about it now. Don't bother with the gate unless you can confirm that there's no chance of a shop, because all shops never move. There's a static dot there that I can see, so I'm going for that one. And it's just a stupid prank that I do not know. So, back to the gate. Because this is needed. Notice how the idiot angel took damage, because it was on the side. Bother with me anymore. Another static dot over there. All the enemies here. Next. Okay, what else is there this time? Man, every one of those moves. So, find the gate. That's my ambush technique I use. I love using it, it's my favorite thing. Just wait for the enemy to come close, like that, get off the side, and leave there. Could be a potential shop room, but unlucky on the shop, because there's none there. There's apparently about a 5% chance of getting a shop. again, don't bother reading anything. Of course, you could sell the junk you got. Good item for accuracy if you're wanting it. This is a must-have item. But I'm not getting it because I have enough boosters. Next floor. Things will start getting a little more dangerous now because the multiplier is now 5x instead of 4x. The multiplier? Well, every area has an area stat multiplier that boosts the power of enemies more than what they would normally be. Those first 20 floors have 20. The first 20 floors have 4x for the multiplier. The next 20 floors have 5x. It increases by 1 every 20 floors you go. Those ones are practically harmless. If you want, you can use one of these orb things here to split a cloud. It's extra experience, in case you're wondering what it's good for. The shield snail seems really irritating. And again, just keep continuing until you get a shop. I'm going to delete you if I found one. Okay. Must have been confused there. Yep, that's what I thought. Pointing in the wrong direction. Anyway, deleting until I'm available. Turns out there are no shops in the first 30 floors. There is actually a significance to that. That is, I need to go through it again. I'm going to go strengthen that one level 5 item. See how powerful that gets in that little bit? Over 100 on those stats. What a beast of an item. And yet I'm getting even stronger yet. But since I did not get what I'm looking for, sell the garbage. No shops ever appeared in any of that. When that happens, choose escape. When you're back, you may have noticed that you've gotten a fair bit of GP, but it's hardly anything. Save your game, as you've made some progress, at least. You take the one that's the oldest. And after you're done saving, repeat this process until you get a shop. And when you do, I'll explain how you do it. If you encounter zombies along the way when you're trying to get Renya to level up, this will be a little more difficult than usual. Okay, when this happens, let that one resurrect. When it does, pick it up and throw it back where you picked it up. Now, drag it and rear it over to where all the action is. Make sure you keep your group together. Let them attack if necessary. There's four zombies. I wonder if there's any more. Which reason is here? That's probably a sleeping thing. Actually, glitched one. What do you know? It's glitched. You can't use the circle and X just to maneuver because you're always adjacent to a zombie. So you have to use slow, meticulous way. And when you have more than one zombie like this, have it off to the side, like so, with a ranged attack that does not result in movement. And you can get all five zombies like that. This is going to be some ridiculous leveling. Ready? Yeah, I've easily got the defense. Now I just need a shop if they would ever appear.